How should you build your app, native or hybrid? Today, we'll break down that decision into six major factors and hopefully leave you with a clearer sense of the right approach for you. Let's get to it. Hybrid frameworks have been around since smartphones were invented. I've written a whole bunch of native apps for iOS and Android, and I've written hybrid apps on most of the major frameworks, and I've been helping people make this particularly critical technology decision for over a decade. For simplicity, I'm going to assume that you're committed to having an app in the App Store rather than just making a website. So, given that, let's discuss the two ways to build. First, building natively, that is to say, in the native languages of the operating system. These days, that's Swift for iOS and Kotlin for Android. You build two apps, one for each platform. And then the second method is building using a hybrid framework like React Native or Flutter. These are designed to be single code bases that produce apps for both iOS and Android. So you write everything once with one team and deploy to both platforms. We're going to break all this down, but if there's one thing you should take away today, it's this. Building natively is how iOS and Android apps are intended to be built. If you're going to do it differently, you have to seek out apps that are built with the same technologies you plan to use and make sure they meet your standards, because if they don't and you can't find anything that does, you shouldn't count on being the first company to do it. Okay, there's a lot to consider here. Let's just hash it all out. Factor one, redundant work. The challenge with building native apps is that if you want to maximize your user base, you need two apps, one for iOS, one for Android. We just went over this. This adds logistical overhead trying to keep your apps in sync, and it leads to redundant work building the same features on two platforms. And this is the key problem hybrid frameworks try to solve. They do this very well under certain conditions and worse under others. If your app is simple, you can probably get most or all of the way on that single code base. But anything that the hybrid framework can't handle is going to have to be written natively. And what this means is that as your project matures and your needs grow beyond the capabilities of the hybrid framework, your risk is that the framework's value becomes negative, because now you've gone from writing all your code in one framework with one team to needing three teams, one code base for hybrid, one for iOS, and one for Android. And on top of that, the code bases are all interwoven instead of being largely independent of each other. And there's just a whole bunch of overhead just understanding how they all interact. So hybrid frameworks move from efficient to inefficient as your app becomes more complex. Do you need two apps right away? A common way to build a more complex app on a budget is to just start with a single platform, usually iOS, because the average amount spent amongst that user base is higher than Android. If you do find success on that platform, it becomes easier to raise the money to build on Android too. That may or may not be right for your business, but it's worth considering. Factor two, slickness and polish. There are technical reasons for this that I won't go into, but as a general rule, hybrid frameworks are slower and less polished than native apps. These differences can be subtle with simple apps and obvious with complex apps. And at a certain point, you just have to do it native. So if the heart of your app is giving your users a fairly simple tool and the polish and slickness isn't a primary concern, then hybrid is okay here. Factor three, staying current. Native apps are built in technologies that Apple and Google expect most teams to build in. When Apple releases the new iOS, when Google releases their latest version of Android, the development tools that ship with each release are built primarily to serve that base of native app developers first. Once those tools are released, the developers of the hybrid frameworks need to update all their systems to support the new features, and some features might not even be feasible. So with a hybrid framework, you're occasionally going to be a little behind the times, and there's a chance that you'll hit a wall in what can be done. With native, that is not the case. Factor four, labor cost. Native app engineers are typically more expensive than engineers that work with hybrid frameworks. The gap has been closing over time, but it still exists. Add the increased labor from not having a centralized code base, and the costs can be significantly higher to get to both platforms with native. Factor five, web compatibility. Both the major hybrid frameworks, React Native and Flutter, can deploy to web, and this is flat out impossible with native apps. So if a web app is an important part of your offering and your functionality is sufficiently simple, the hybrid frameworks start getting pretty cost effective. Factor six, logistics. When you have a centralized code base, it's easier to keep everything in sync. When you have two teams, the teams can end up moving at different velocities and features can arrive on different platforms at different times. There are ways to manage this. If you're working with more senior level engineers, they can often build a new feature on their dominant platform and then port it to the other platform themselves. So you get the same engineer working across both platforms. And this can be pretty efficient, makes it much easier to keep features in sync, but this is harder for less experienced engineers to contribute to. Okay, summing it up, if you aren't particularly budget conscious, there's little reason to build with a hybrid framework. If budget is a concern, and your app is simple, you can handle it not being the slickest, most polished app in its category, hybrid frameworks are a really good way to save money and get the job done. Hi, my name's Rich. I've been programming since the late 90s and building apps since 2009. I've led app development at successful startups, a couple of teams at Google, and in 2019, I left Google to start my own firm here in Half Moon Bay, California. I still love this work. If you are building something new or struggling with an app you already built, I would love to chat about it. Please reach out, and I hope you find these videos useful.